Folks, Andrew here of GoPro Wrestling, and I'm standing with Jumping Jim Brunzel. Thank you so much for joining us, a true wrestling legend in the sport of professional wrestling.
Thank you very much, Andrew. It's always nice to be able to communicate with the fans. You know, they've been following Brian and I for years, and it's sort of nice to still be relevant, you know, 31 years after you were with the WWE.
Yeah, and one of my favorite things that you and Brian used to do is the Killer Bees. You used to switch the masks towards the end of the match, and it would be the only times.
I do that now with my bank withdrawals. But the big thing was, it was a surprise. Here's my partner, Brian, here.
Introducing Brian Blair. Be Brian Blair, folks. Thank you.
Good to be here. Always good to be with you, brother. What's happening?
Very great.
Always good to be with Jumpin' Jim.
So
did you read his book? It's awesome.
Yeah, I was just talking about it with
him. I like it.
It's called
awesome t-shirts too, man.
It's called Matlands, and these are some stories. You have some stories in WWF in here, or
yes. It took me about 5 years. You know, I had three really great tag team partners. Mike George, there you go, Mike George in Kansas City, and then Greg Gagne with the AWA, and of course B. Brian Blair with the WWE as the Killer Bees. So I was very fortunate. We had a great career. And like I say, it's always fun to come out and see the fans.
There are a lot of great pictures in here. These are your own pictures in here?
Yes, these are from my my own personal library. There's a couple, there's only one that might be considered a little racy, but it was in good humor that we did it.
All right, racy. Then, you know, O'Neill, give me 20 bucks. How much do you need for this?
Ah, good. Is that right, Joe?
There you go. Here, keep this.
Thank you, Andrew. Thank you.
I appreciate that. I can't wait to read it.
By the bathroom, it'll be about a 3-hour read. You get it done in less than a week.
Now, do you have any book at all, Brian, that you have written?
Yeah, I do, Andrew. I wrote one a long time ago for the kids, you know, that were asking about, you know, the terms of wrestling and how to speak carny, because some of the guys would speak as Arnie. And when we broke into the business, you had to speak as Arnie or speak carny, or you couldn't get into the business, because if somebody said Dizek the Piz unstuck the punch, and I went to punch him and he didn't duck. That's how Steve Kern got his teeth knocked out by Bob Orton Jr. So that was part of our training. But you know, we're getting a little older now, but we've been around the world, that's for sure, Andrew. As a matter of fact, you know, we've been from Maine to Spain, we've been deep down in the Ukraine. Jumpin' Jim and I have actually been from ocean to ocean, from coast to coast. We've been north, south, east, and west. And you know something? Don't ask me who's the best until I've kissed the rest, because we've seen a lot of fine women along our days. But you know, Jimmy's a happily married man.
42 years.
And so am I. But I give me hugs too and kisses to the young ladies and the old ladies and the babies for free.
Where are some of the nice women that you guys have seen?
You can't kiss me, Andrew.
No. I mean, but in what towns would you say this? Since you brought up the subject.
All right. Where's the best ladies?
Yeah.
Southern ladies. Well, then again, Australia's nice. And if you get a little
we're all
kinky,
married. I don't want to get us all
kinky
in trouble.
If you get a little kinky, the Japanese are a lot of fun. Itai.
That was long ago. But what, you know, I wanted to ask you guys.
J.J. Dillon, my God. Oh, my gosh, my hero, J.J. Dillon. I love that guy.
I wanted to ask you guys, you guys were instrumental in during the tag team days.
All right, JJ.
Cameo of JJ Dillon.
Great tag team partner.
Nice to see you again.
Andrew, how are you?
How are you?
These are two of the greatest of all time.
I worked with him since 79.
And I've never been the same since. I still can't write straight. But no, he's one of the best. Both of them. Great team, too. Good luck,
JJ. Thank you. God bless.
Very good.
JJ's a great supporter of the Cauliflower Alley Club. If you go to caulifloweralleyclub.org for $25, you can be a member of the greatest fraternity on earth. 100% of the money goes to help wrestlers that have fallen on difficult financial hardships. And you get four awesome newsletters that are four color, along with a certificate suitable for framing. And you get to come to our reunion, which is once a year. Jumpin' Jim's been there. He's actually was honored into the CAC Hall of Fame, him and Greg, the High Flyers, 2 years ago. And it was awesome. So we're proud to have Jim as a member and to be honored. And we always have some of the greatest wrestlers in the whole business. There was Ken Patera with you that year, Paul Orndorff, guy that, who else was there? The guy from Memphis, Jerry Lawler. Just so many guys. It's amazing. So come out to Vegas 2018, May 30th through April 2nd, but you got to join the club first. CauliflowerAlleyClub.org.
Andrew, I just wanted to say in closing, the reason why we like J.J. Dillon so much is we're hoping that he puts a good word in to Vince McMahon at the WWE so Brian and I can be inducted in their Hall of Fame, because it's long overdue. So come on, Vince. Bury the hatchet. We love you.
It's really long overdue. I know you guys got to go, but yes. Quick question. The tag team ranks today, it's not the same as it was when you guys were there. You had Demolition, Strikeforce, all these great tag teams. What do you think needs to happen today for tag team wrestling to rise how it was when you guys were there?
Well, establish at least two or three teams. And I think everybody, if you watch their tag teams now, they don't have tag teams per se. They'll have an eight-man tag or a six-man tag. And it just takes away from the intricacy of tag team wrestling, which Brian and I were a great part of.
Is there anybody today right now in the WWE that you could see as a future star if you were to watch the current product today?
Well, I mean, the ones I see are already stars. The ones that I really appreciate have already made money. They're already stars. The younger guys, but even Sheamus has already been a star. I predicted him to be a star when I saw him first train. And he turned out to be a heck of a performer. I really like Sheamus. He's a good guy, too. Probably my favorite performer right now is Bob Orton Jr., Randy Orton.
Randy, he's the best.
Bob Orton Jr.'s son. And actually knew his father, Bob Orton Sr., so that whole lineage of family means a lot. And to see Randy Orton Jr. understands old school, new school, in between, up and down, he can do it all. He was a great amateur wrestler. He's a tremendous athlete.
Real quickly, a lot of fans want to know, you and Sheik bury the hatch?
I don't really have that bad a grudge against Sheik. You know, I love everybody, and he's just had a lot of hard times. I wish him well. When we see each other, it's kind of, I think that issue is fading, if you will.
It's like one big happy family. To close us out, do you have anything you finally want to say to the fans?
No, thank you for your patronage throughout the years, and hopefully in the future years we'll have an opportunity to take a picture with you and sign our books and our comic books, too, that are coming out. Yeah, grab one of those, too. Doggone it.
Anything to promote the true stuff.
Killer Bees in 2017. Thank you.
True stories.
Folks, you heard it here. We want to see the B. Brian Blair jumping Jim Brunzel in the WWE Hall of Fame. Ellis, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you, Andrew.
Thank you, Andrew. Enjoyed it, man.
Thank you.